Hello, this video is about how to take care of an abandoned baby parrot. A baby that fell from its nest has a greater risk of falling again and unfortunately low chances of survival. It is best to locate its nest and reunite it with its parents, otherwise take it to a bird's shelter or bird's rescuers or caretaker. However, if you have none of these options or any help, then congratulations, you have a baby. Before handling the baby, you must wash your hands and sanitize them, as babies have higher risk of catching infection or bacteria. The first thing to do is immediately make the baby warm. Such small baby can easily catch cold, which will be fatal. You need to cover it with warm clothes. Get it warm near a heater or through light of a lamp. Even if it's summers, you must get the baby in a very warm place. In case of emergency, any heater, even a car's heater, will be the best option. Next is hydration. Give the baby 5-6 drops of clean lukewarm water, so it feels hydrated. If it's a very small baby, then not more than 3 drops. Our purpose is to hydrate the baby only if it has been on its own for too long. While the baby gets warm, you need to prepare food. In case of emergency, you can give it baby food stage 1 rice formula. Baby parrots should be fed the proper feed, which is easily available at any bird stores. Do not feed baby anything else until it's more than 4 weeks old. Use amount of water, as per instruction on the box. We want the food to be smooth enough to swallow. Food must be always warm. Babies can catch cold from digesting cold food too. There are many utensils you can use to feed the baby. You can use a syringe after removing the needle, a soft plastic spoon, and if you can find a straw like this one. I got this from Baskin Robbins. It has soft smooth edges. Please do not try to do this with ordinary straws. The sharp edges will harm the baby. You can also use small rubber pipe available at any bicycle repair shops or spare parts store. When the food is warm enough to eat, drop the formula in the syringe. Push the plunger so the air bubble gets clear and it's ready for a smooth feeding. Now keep the bird close to you so can easily open its mouth. A scared bird is difficult to feed. You have to be very careful not to poke its eyes with the utensils or your fingers. Focus on the beak and position the bird so the food can run down its throat. Some people flush down the whole syringe in the bird, which looks uncomfortable, and the bird also looks sick. I try to empty the syringe in 4 parts so the bird enjoys the food and won't vomit it out. Feeding such small baby will take time, so you will have to be patient. Once baby is few days old, it will try to eat food from the spoon itself when it's hungry. These innocent creatures are without parents' love and care, so we must show them extra kindness and gently handle them. The baby starts vibrating or flaps its wings. That's how they respond to their mothers at feeding time. Baby parrot has a pouch in front of it, which is called crop, as in its stomach. It's an indicator when it's full. The crop will be very small or flat when it's hungry. The baby might keep asking for more food, but you need to stop once its crop gets full. For the first week, you will have to feed it every 2-3 hours, except at night you can feed it after 4-6 hours. Once baby is fed, you need to make a home for it. These guys fit easily in small boxes like shoe box. I have placed some scraps of cloth on the bottom, then a soft cloth to cover and flatten the area. Since baby will be wetting the bed, you should keep 2 big pieces of cloth or use paper towels or napkins. Make the surface flat and its corners securely tucked in, otherwise baby can get itself tangled in the threads. This is a temporary initial home where baby will stay warm. You can move it to a hand-woven nest with soft straw so baby's skin won't get hurt. To cover the edges and sharp corners, you can pull up the middle of the cloth, so it turns into a tent and baby can move freely. You can also leave its box under a lamp, so it gets heat. The temperature should be 35 to 38 Celsius. Cover the box with its cover, or a thin piece of cloth so baby not get bitten by any insects. Make sure to make holes in the box, or cut a small strip in the middle of the box so baby can get air. You can keep by a closed window for an hour for sunlight. However, keep an eye so the baby won't get too hot or dehydrated. You can check its injuries once baby is comfortable. This baby fell on its back and knee. I used massaged with petroleum jelly for baby's sensitive skin at night, and that rebuilds skin quickly. Here are some signs where baby should be immediately taken to a good vet. Delay will cause in baby's sudden death, as they are too sensitive to deal with medical issues, and these signs can be fatal. Usually abandoned birds already have developed infections or injuries after falling from a great height, so it's better to have a checkup by a good vet, even if the bird appears to be healthy. Alarming signs are when the baby starts sneezing, which means it has caught cold. Its poop becomes white, which can be sign of digestive organ disorder. It is repeatedly shivering or twitches. Skin color can change, or it has problem in moving due to broken bone, injured muscle. It is having difficulty in breathing, stopped sleeping, sudden slow behavior, constipation or diarrhea, refusing to eat, dehydrated, fever or bleeding, vomiting. Parrots, like humans, can talk, and you will notice the baby making painful sounds when it gets ill. You should take it to animal emergency hospital, and always keep close by vet's contacts handy, so you can get immediate help. Do not handle the bird too much, as we can transfer germs to the babies easily. These are some of the harmful things for baby birds that can be fatal. Refined sugar is a big no. Do not add sugar in any of its food. Too much water will fill up its lungs. Only a couple of drops. If baby is dehydrated, even small injuries or a minor cold can kill the baby. Overheat exposure will dehydrate the baby, and can burn its soft skin. Do not cook its food in non-stick cookware, because its coating is poisonous for babies. Smoke or toxic fumes. Long delays in feeding, starvation. Kids and other pets cannot handle the baby delicately, and the baby should be kept in a safe warm place. Overcooked or cold food and some plants are dangerous for baby parrots. Avocado, rhubarb, dangerous for even adult parrots. Not all fruit seeds are good for parrots, some can be very harmful. You will fall in love with the baby, as parrots respond to you like human babies. You will enjoy playing with them. Toys, sounds and colors stimulate their intelligent minds. However, do not leave any toys in baby's nest or box until it is grown up. Toys should be safe, so baby won't chew them. They love you back unconditionally and always looking to get your attention. Parrots are wonderful, as they start saying words that you repeatedly use in front of them, especially at the time of feeding. Raising them is a beautiful, memorable time, and they win your heart with each passing day. Think of the maximum comfort and relief you want during sickness. Similarly, these innocent creatures need love and relief from pain. These little orphans can tell you what they need, what is hurting them. They get separated from their parents for life. Saving a life and helping it grow is the most wonderful experience in the world. You will always stay their life-saving hero. Thanks for watching. Please share this video so people know what to do when they find abandoned baby birds.
A video by Rabia Noreen Khawaja, NRN Life, a project of NRN Enterprise. Please visit www.nrnenterprise.com for more videos, welfare projects, donate and contribute in saving innocent lives.